Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Endless Legend. Playing as the Roving Clans. In the last episode, we settled our first city and nearly finished the first part of our faction quest. That's where we'll continue. Order this. Yeah. Took a bit of damage, but it's not too bad. Oh yes, we have one of those offered. Definitely want to get her. What should be the first or two tech? Probably this one. Let's queue up. Him after this, or even before it, and a settler after the burrow. /227. So that's exactly 50 dust that I need. Suppose I'll sell my titanium. Whoops. Dust efficiency and army health boost. Now, I've already. Oh, she is locked for another turn. So, what I'll do is assign the hero we got at the start, already has 2 points in the skill, to our second city next turn. And then assign the hero I just bought either to a capital or to the army to replace this one. What did we get? Roads of Dust. Ah yeah, this is a very good one. Thank you. It is said by the sages that any undertaking must balance the influence of the past, the present, and the future. With a city established and troops at my command, I felt that present was more secure than it had been for some time. As for my plans for the future, they depend very much on what I had discovered in the ruins from the past. For upon Auriga, the past is a weighty thing indeed. The relics I had recovered hinted at something truly enormous, a great complex of wonders and wizardry, hidden somewhere beneath our very feet. Curse me thrice if I did not weep with joy at the discovery, for dust is not merely Italian currency, it is stuff that has great power on its own, and should I amass it in the quantities that I saw in my dreams, I was sure that I could shape the very stuff of which our world is made. The ancient whispers and legends I had heard held some grain of truth, but ah, how much? Well, that's going to be easy, seeing as how I already have a Wild Walker's hero that's in a city. So, I'll need some more dust. Also, never forget to search ruins with a quest twice. Assign. Alright, next turn. I thought I've already ended the turn. Want to clear those two villages next? Give that guy. Whoops, on equipment, of course. I don't think I have the gold to do anything useful. So let's just attack. I think I'll do it manually. That's unfortunate. Well, lucky for me, that one survived with one health, and you just saw the power of the free counter. Come on. siege, or they might not. They don't. Great. Let's build that before the settler. Should be fine. Give her one of those. Now, do I value the dust over the population point? The dust probably does more. One population point is 4 food. Well, this is way more than 5 dust. Silex. Want to clear those as well because they are so close to my city. And I'm going to move this one close because I might bait them into attacking. And with these reinforcements, I'll be able to take them without endangering this dervish here. They are attacking, right? Yeah. Geomic labs, Barrow streets, can't afford and plan, it's 40. Yep. And I can assimilate the haunts, which I forgot to do 4 turns ago. Stun one is 20%? 10%. That's not very high. I of course want all those reinforcements. And these seem to be faster for some reason. So, I'll have those stay back for now. These attack the closer ones. Okay. because these will move to the forest hall. What, this one or this one, and won't be able to move further. Well, these will either move here, where they can't shoot, or move here, where they also can't shoot because they've used up all the movement. And the same thing again. They'll move. We'll be unable to shoot. Yeah, exploiting their low range is a much easier way to win battles against them than just sending in my cavalry. Will they reinforce a second time? They will. Great. Now they have just one speed. So really... That's the one I want shooting at them. And I want to do it from high ground. 1, 2, 3, yep. Militia, go charging in, be brave. And just defend or do whatever. Not sure if there is such a thing as defense in this game. Can fire one more shot from this position. They'll come up. Okay, easy. I want this one as a governor as well. Let's give her a bow as well. This one might be useful against those tactite thingies. Really, no way to speed this up. ~59 signs per turn, that's all right. I'll have to do it manually. Sadly, this time there are no forests to exploit. Well, there are these ones, but aren't quite positioned where I want them to be. Okay, these ones will move first and move. Oh, there's a cliff here, so I'll go here, here, then these will follow to here. And I have a range of 2, 1, 2. And so I really just need to be here. Knowing the actual move order makes this so much easier. Here, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Of course, I forgot that they are faster than me again. Christ. And build this one here as well. It delays the settler though. Not worth it. I think those were orcs, yes. That case. I'll heal up in the city. Now this is just a guess, but you might get more health regeneration per turn while you're in friendly cities. It wouldn't make sense to me. How much until I can fulfill that quest after the Geomic Labs? Five in the capital, yeah. I really need to build the seed storage after the winter ends. Though it's just one upkeep. Maybe I should have built this much earlier. It would have had a few turns of 10 more growth. With more river tiles after that, and then I can queue up the dust on rivers building. Doesn't seem like there are any useful anomalies. Close enough. Okay, 10 approval if I go this way. I might want to go down here and have those free lake tiles for another 10 dust per turn. Of course, that'll require a few barrows, well, two for those two. I think I'll do that. And I'd probably research an approval tech before I'm done with the borrow, and then I'll assert it before that in the queue. And I may as well add that as well. Have it be done roughly when winter ends. How's the health looking here? I want to see 67, 92. So, if it's 10 per turn, I should be recovering 16 health. Okay, that's 83. Yep, it's 10%. Great. Because I've noticed before it was 5%. Winter started. The normal debuffs. Fifteen glass steel. That's really good. Really need that. It is said that the open mind profits more than the closed one. Indeed, studies and indications that were brought by these heroes from other nations increased my knowledge of Auriga. And as always, with knowledge came power. Next we had to divine and test and excavate to understand more of this world and the ways that dust has enhanced it. For dust has always been the rhythm and lifeblood of Auriga, as the market is the rhythm and lifeblood of the clans. And those marvelous resources, the fruit of a world touched by dust and ancient gods, would certainly have more to tell me. Okay, 50 resources, strategic and luxury. Seems doable. This one, then this one. Although I might want this one before those. do want both of those as well. Seven. Eight. Nine. So I'll want sewers. Titanium or glass steel, or maybe this one. Yeah, maybe I should settle up here. In that case, let me. Yep, I have the movement tech. Let's. Retrofit. Oh god, that was stupid. I just got a new era. Why would I retrofit now without upgrading my designs? Probably can't afford it, no. Want to reactivate the emeralds right now. It wouldn't actually improve my approval at all. is very good. So I'll really want to settle here. Still here. This will also be a priority then. There's two glass stills here. I've completely missed that. Probably because there isn't a good location to settle. Well, I've pacified everything in this region already, so I might want to go here, but there's three villages that are right next to the borders, so I'm unsure about that move, especially with my army right now being up here. Not orcs. I think I can take them. If you don't want to have enemy reinforcements, attack their Roman armies, not the villages first. Have those stand back, and this one will go first, so 1, 2, 3, 4, I'll actually be able to attack, which is unfortunate. He won't move. Whoops. I want to move this one. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I move those away, I can shoot at him. Just stand there, really. What an exciting turn. More stats on those, it's definitely welcome. Ah, oh, blessed summer. And approval. Get that first. Settler done, Dust Dredger done, Central Market here, and Central Market here as well. Those are ranged slayers. Fairly fast ones as well. But I can attack this village and then move out of their line of sight. This is really good in defensible terrain, but they'll be able to charge me. There is no cliff here. Maybe like this, have them chase those guys. I shoot at them. I'll just run somewhere here. Maybe you go there and you go here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Should work. Oh, they're blocking each other, very nice. In that case, since they aren't intent on chasing my cavalry, Let's lock them up. And well, why are they attacking this guy? Should have been one each, so this one can't move anymore. Yeah, disorders, fine though. Instead of the forests, I could settle here as well for the dust on anomalies. Maybe here. How fast are those? 28. And I'm faster than them. So with Flying Slayer I can actually defeat them quite easily. Quest. And a tech that I actually want. Alright, let's queue up those. They'll do something, I guess. I'll determine a good spot for that settler next episode. That's looking fairly good so far. Of course I can't look at the stat screen because I haven't encountered the other AIs. Thanks for watching, see you next time.